everyone, Dr. Sonia Chopra here, and I wanted to take the time to answer a really important question. One thing that I get asked a lot about is, when do you decide when to do a root canal in one visit versus two visits? So I think that's a really important question, and I find that it depends upon the case, so it's always a case-by-case decision. But here are some of the things that kind of guide my decision. Usually when I get an emergency patient, one that is a same-day treatment that I have to kind of work into my schedule, that type of patient is not going to be getting treatment all done in one visit just because of a time perspective. I don't really have the time to take that case to completion, so I'm doing more of a pulpectomy or a full pulpal debridement normally in order to make sure that the patient has enough pain control to move on with their life. Secondly, I do my retreatments in two visits. Retreatments always tend to be way more infected than a tooth that's just getting an initial root canal. So most of my retreatments, I would say 98% of my retreatments actually get treatment done in two visits. Sometimes I will do a retreatment in one visit if it's like an anterior tooth that I need to get back to the general dentist right away because they need to restore it with a post and core. So sometimes I do make an exception to that rule. Or if they're just getting a retreatment because there's been some coronal leakage and there's no real periapical radiolucency, so I feel like once I just refresh the gutta percha, the case is done. So I would say 98% of my retreatments are done in two visits. If a tooth is too symptomatic, if the patient comes in with a lot of pain, it's not really a great idea to do that root canal in one visit. I always want my patient to go back to the general dentist pain-free, so I really kind of want to control that, and if they're feeling too bad, then I want to medicate the tooth with calcium hydroxide, make sure that they can actually function on the tooth by the time they go back to get their final restoration. Obviously, if a patient is swollen or if they're draining in any way, I don't want to do it in one visit. I'll prefer two visits. Again, I want their infection to be completely resolved before I start to obturate that canal. If a patient is feeling me during treatment, so sometimes I have every intention of filling that tooth in one visit, going from start to finish, but if they are really uncomfortable during the procedure, then I definitely want to take my time. I don't ever want to rush things, and I think that's one of the beauties of root canal therapy is that you can just close it up and come back to it another day. So never rush your treatment. Always take your time and make sure your patient is pain-free before they get their crown. Sometimes when a periapical radiolucency is just way too big, I don't want to, again, rush the case because some of those cases actually will need some surgical intervention in between as well. They won't heal with just root canal therapy. So every now and then with a really big periapical radiolucency, I will do them in two visits. When there's something special going on in the tooth, maybe there's some resorption or there's some special anatomy, like C-shape anatomy, again, I'll take my time and do the case over two visits, and sometimes it has to be multiple visits. And the last thing is that maybe it's a hard tooth. You know, not every root canal is going to be a slam dunk for me. Some things that I think that are going to look so straightforward on the radiograph are actually really hard when I get inside. So when I talk to a patient, when I'm talking to them and orienting them with their procedure during the evaluation, I let them know that, you know, you should really expect two visits for your root canal, but hope for one. I never promise anybody one visit root canal therapy, even though I probably do it about 85-90% of the time. But, you know, root canals are really technique sensitive, and I want to take my time, and I want that patient to have quality care, and I want to make sure that I never have to look back at that tooth ever again. That should be the last time that it's ever treated with a root canal. So that's kind of how I work. I hope that you kind of took away some pearls from that, and I hope it really helps you out. Have a great day.